It's R.A. Gorgeous Energy. This is day 26 of 2020. Today we're going to talk about comparison and how it is the most evil thing that is kind of like disguised as separation, which is the game of day one, like the beginning of life, the beginning on earth, the beginning of everything, you know, the get-go. Comparison has literally been this most powerful way to separate people, and that's why I had this quote. This preach was inspired by a quote that I channeled from a higher being. Thank you. It went like this. This is going to be also in the next post after this thing. It says, comparison is separation disguised as motivation under control. Which means that comparison is there to motivate us to feel like we need to compare with each other. We need to compare and compete, I should say. So pretty much, step one is to compare us with each other, and then to compete with each other after we compare and see, hey, this person is better than me, or I need to be better than them, you know. And then when that evilness is there, that evil, like, hey, I need to be better, then that's where where competition is born. And then with competition we get separation, because then what happens is, if we can't really be better than the other person, and if that person is better than us, then the evil comes in and we feel like, wow, that person is not even like my friend, we're not the same, that person is whack, or that person is better, or that person is greedy, or that person is an asshole. Pretty much we start putting names and tags and just titles, and just that's when separation actually goes into full effect, because at this point we realize that those people we should not even be with them. That literally, separation is literally ignited, and therefore we just become separated from our loved ones, from our friends, relatives, peers, employees, workers. We almost feel like that's how literally the CEOs are separated from their employees, because they feel like, hey, I'm compared to them, I'm not on their level, I own the company. But at the end, they don't know that they're just reflections of them, and those people are another aspect of them. So they don't actually get this. But once they do, and they never do actually, unless they have like spiritual awakening and they lose everything and then they go through like the hero journey, that's when they actually get it. But other than that, they actually don't get it, and they just feel like they just literally die one day. They don't die on there, but one day when they're on their deathbed, they kind of have this regret, remorse of like, how do we not know this? That's only if they have their spiritual awakening by then. But most people don't. They just literally go through life and they just go from born to the grave without knowing this. But so I'm here to tell you guys, so you guys can, if you don't know this already, and it's all about awareness. I'm not judging anyone here. This channel, this, my whole purpose of life, my objective as a earth sign, as a, as the fire element and the earth element, is to create peace in the world. And how do you create peace? By awareness, you know? And with that said, let's get out this preach and let's get to it. Okay, today I decided to dedicate my daily spiritual preach on the concept of comparison and how to be aware of its pros and cons and execute accordingly with awareness in mind. Literally, like I was just saying, it's all about awareness and how to execute comparison, if you really have to still compare, because at the end of the day, in 3D, you can compare yourself with awareness, which may not be comparison. It'll just be like, yeah, he's just different, or she's just different, or she's just smarter. That's not comparison at that point. That's a compliment, which is a whole different story, get it? So it's a good thing, it's a positive thing, pro. And the con will be like, oh my god, this person is better than me, or he thinks he's a shit, or he thinks he's cooler. No, he's not, I am, you know, that's comparison. All right, and the competition just sneaks up on you there. Okay, many of us are well aware that we are unique in some way or form, yet we compare ourselves to others because we are picking up on the electromagnetic energies of our peers and the electromagnetic fields. And therefore, compare ourselves and compete with them, which is how separation is born. Like, I would just think that literally how it's born. As soon as we compete and we compare each other, separation is born and hatred comes in. From day one, we have been conditioned to play the game of separation, and we accepted that as the norm, and it has become part of us. That's literally what happened. From day one, we have been so instilled with that concept of comparison, etc., that the game of separation, even though we don't see that way, because if we do, we'll kind of, I guess, be more aware and we'll just stop. Game of separation, it is hidden under a lot of layers, like comparison and competition and being better than the next guy, you know? So that's why we never seen the actual game of separation. But as we get spiritually, as we spiritually become more awakened, we see this, and we literally, and once we see this, it's game over, because then we never go back and say, yeah, I'm gonna just go back and start comparing, because it's kind of like, once the Pandora box is open, it's open. You don't close it, because the awareness just kicks in, unless, like, something catastrophic happens, and you lose, and you get coma, or something, like, set point, like a bad set point, or you just have a bad influence, but it's not very common, it's very rare. But the 3D world can cause that sometimes for people to actually go back once in a blue moon when they go through some crazy shit, like someone dies in their family, heaven forbid, or something really bad happens for them to them. But usually it doesn't, because they know the reality, so they kind of go accordingly. But in general, once you are aware separation actually is around you, just that awareness alone will allow you to compare less and live more and love more and just compliment more instead of competing or comparing or separating yourself from your peers, because they are another reflection of you. Okay, if we lived as one and didn't compare each other to each other, then the control, aka money, aka evil, would not function, and we would evolve as species, and the bad shadow government, aka world government, and their higher ups that they report to will fade away, because without separation they will be exposed, those people, and negativity, which is their fuel to thrive and survive, will be in short supply, since everyone will be blissful as one, as people will literally be as one, like unity. And what that's saying is, once the people are aware and they live as one, they will not compare themselves to each other, therefore they will not have any kind of hate, they will not have frustration. I mean, of course, there will be some downs and like ups and downs just in general, but they'll just be all in love with each other, like in a very clean way. Like, they will just feel like they are part of each other. They're like family, so there's no point of comparing. And then the violence will be gone, and the violence usually creates negativity and negative energy. So violence will be chopped off, it'll be literally faded. Hate will be faded, racism will be faded, sexism will be faded, feminism will be faded. Like, a lot of things that are right now very popular and trending, because the news media wants that to happen, so they'll, because they kind of work for the shadow government, they're owned by it, so they have to make people feel negative and in this super sad misery state, for the negative energies to actually take over and just kind of like take over the world. Well, they're taking over the world, but it's for the negative energies to actually be harvested by the evil and actually use them to fulfill their agenda, which is really happening every single day. Whenever one thing happens somewhere, like the Australian fire thing, the whole world right now is talking about that. So more fires are being created because people are creating the fire. That fire it could have lived short if we didn't think about it so much. I'm not saying be careless, but be careful a little, meaning don't think about something so much and let it just be. I'm not trying to sound careless here or just heartless, but that's just the way it is. Like, if we don't think about things, they will not, it's kind of like we feel that because we're creating that reality over and over again because it's in our heads and we project whatever we think outside of our bodies and our reality. So if we keep on thinking about the Australian fires, that will continue for maybe even a year, hopefully not, or more. So it's very important for us to be aware that when we allow that our brains to just kind of be taken over by the media, we are not in control anymore and the evil has won. So going back here is, once we are aware that we are all one, they will not have any power over us, therefore we will be in full control, and therefore we'll be as one, we'll be one social memory complex. That's the key term for like one consciousness. And at that point, the evil, the dark government, the shadow government, whatever you want to call it, the Illuminati, that's the other term, so that the YouTube video will not be banned, those people will have no power because they are fueled. It's kind of like that is their food. Our sadness, our misery, our frustrations, our violence, our everything you can think of, our depression, our suicide rates, our even cigarette, alcohol, everything, it influences them to you because everything has negative connotation, has a negative side effects. Those things, everything, it fuels their survival. That's how they thrive in this world. That's how they control us, because if we're giving them that much power, then they have more power to actually just create more negativity and control what already exists to even prosper more into more negativity, so they can even prosper themselves. That's just the reality. Lastly, this weekend, whatever activities you engage in, make sure that it is from the origin of oneness as one, and see the feedback and energy that you feel from your engaged parties. Just do that and see what happens. Just treat everyone like they are you and don't compare them, just kind of compliment them and see the response, and you'll be like mind blown how beautiful it is. You'll actually feel good about yourself. You'll feel warm sensation in your heart. Just remember, and this is the quote that I said earlier, but I'm just kind of like paraphrasing it in the ending. Just remember that comparison is separation disguised as motivation under their control. So feel wholeness and you will feel complete without a doubt or comparison. Stay Vibey, much love, R.I.P. Chosen. That's literally the key, is to just feel wholeness and feel complete and know that you are enough and you are a whole. And there's no point of comparing yourself and how original and how genuine you are to someone else that is not. And that's it. Have an amazing evening. And like always, much love, peace, and namaste. Stay Vibey and united.